Next, we have this question of NIELIT 2017 CS. And this question says, computer uses 46 bits virtual address and 32 bit virtual physical address and a 3-level page table organization. Okay, we know that what is the definition of 3-level page table. It is given in the question. The complete definition of a 3-level page table is given in the question itself. It is saying the page table uses base register to store the base address of the first level page table. Okay, first level which occupies exactly one page. This sentence is very important, which occupies exactly one page. This will help us to solve the question. Each entry of T1 stores the base address of a page table of the second level table. Okay, there is no actual page table entries in this page table. It is actually storing the addresses of the page tables itself. Each entry of T2 stores the base address of a page table of the third level page table. So on the third level, we have many page tables, and in level 2 page table, what we are doing is each entry in level 2 page table stores the base address of each page table in the level 3. Each entry of T3 stores a page table entry. The page table entry is of 32 bits. Okay, 32 bits, that is 4 bytes. The processor used in this computer has a 1 MB 16-way set associative virtually indexed and physically tagged cache. This is the logic in this question. Virtually indexed and physically tagged cache. Okay, so we are using virtually indexed and physically tagged cache. The block size of this cache is 64 bytes. So this question is asking, what is the size of a page in this system? Okay, what is the size of the page in KB in this computer? So this question is actually taken from the 2013 GATE CS paper, and we have two questions in this part. Okay, 93 is a question. We have this data. On this data, we have two questions, 93 and question number 94. So let's see how we will solve this question. There is a new concept which was introduced in the GATE 2017 paper, that is virtual indexed physically tagged cache. So first we will see what is virtual indexed and physically tagged cache, then we will try to solve the question, because without knowing this concept, you will not be able to solve this question. So we have four kind of caches. First is, okay, maybe some of these caches cannot be implemented, but we have concepts like virtually indexed and virtually tagged cache. Then we have virtually indexed physically tagged cache. Then we have physically indexed and virtually tagged. And we know the obvious combination, fourth obvious combination, that is physically indexed and physically tagged cache. So we have these four kind of caches. Some of them are not implemented actually in real life, but we have these four concepts. Some of these are only concepts. So we will see what is virtually indexed. We are concerned only with virtually indexed and physically tagged cache. Okay, so I have recorded one lecture on these four types of caches. You can watch that lecture. But now I will be explaining this concept, virtually indexed, physically tagged cache. This question is simply the combination of operating system and computer architecture. Okay, these two subjects are combined, and this question is being designed. This is a very beautiful question. We will see how we will solve this question. So let's start from the zero, from where story starts. Okay, so now what happens is CPU want to access something from the memory. So CPU always generate virtual address. Okay, always remember, CPU generates only virtual address. In computer architecture, we only talk about the physical address, but now we are on the operating system. Okay, now we are only talking about the operating system. So in operating system, we divide the address in two parts, that is page number and page offset. Okay, that is P part and offset part, D part. What we do is we take this page number to the page table and search for the frame. Okay, where this page is stored in the actual memory frame. Okay, so here we will find the frame number. We will take this frame number, and offset will be same. Why offset is same? Because the page size is equals to frame size. So we will take this page offset as same as for the memory. Okay, physical memory. Always remember, physical memory can only be accessed with the physical address. But now we have a concept of virtually accessed cache, in which we can access the cache directly with the virtual address, which means we do not need to translate the address from virtual address to physical address. But in this case, normally what we are doing is we are converting virtual address to physical address using the memory management unit, in which we have a page table. Okay, we can store page table in the cache, that is TLB. Okay, TLB is used to store the page table only. Okay, so either we can store the page table in the TLB or we can store the page table in the memory. Actually, page table is stored in the memory, but the subset of this page table is stored in the TLB to make the access fast. So next, what we'll do is we will take the first part, that is label one page table. Okay, we have divided this page number into two parts because now we have two level page table. Okay, so in two level page table, what we have is this page number, these 10 bits will be used to identify the page table in the level one page table. Level one page table will store the addresses of the level two page tables, not the page table entries. Always remember, you can increase any number of levels. Okay, only last level page table will store the actual page table entries. All other tables will store the base addresses of the next level page table. For example, this is level one page table. We have this processor register. Why we are using this? In last table, we will have only one page table, and this register will store the base address of that page table. For example, in this two level page table, we have two level page tables, level one page table and level two page table. So this is the last level page table, and this register is storing the base address of this last level page table. Okay, P1. Always remember, page table levels are starting from the we cannot say this is page level one. This is actually last level. Last level means this is level two. In case of three level page table, this will be level three. Then we will have level two. Then we will have level one. So like this level one page table is storing the base addresses of these page tables. In these page tables, we have actual page table entries. These are the page table entries, actual page table entries, in which we are storing the frame number. So we are doing the indexing of this page table using the page number. Okay, page number. So we are saying page number is stored nowhere in the memory. Page number one is not in memory. For example, let's say page number one is stored in the frame number one. Page number two is stored in the frame number two. Like this, we are converting the virtual address to physical address. So how this is related to our concept of virtual indexed and physically tagged? Let's see. So we have this is the internal architecture of the TLB, that is translation look aside buffer. We have a TLB in which we store the page table. Okay, let's see how we store the page table in the translation look aside buffer. So let's say we have this virtual address of 48 bits. These 48 bits are divided into two parts, page number and offset. 12 bit per page number, that means page sizes. If you have page offset of 12 bits, that means page size is 2 to the power 12, that is 4 KB. Okay, and this is page number, that means we have 2 to the power 36 pages. Okay, like this you can find the size of the virtual memory. Now we are taking these 36 bits to the page table. In page table, this page table is installed in the in and this is stored inside the TLB. Okay, in TLB, except frame number, physical address, we have many things like read write bits, valid bits, invalid bits, tag bits. All these bits are stored in the TLB because TLB is a cache. In cache, we have a tag, index, and maybe offset. And then because this is a TLB, so when we replace any page from the cache, we need the valid or invalid bit, because before replacing the cache, we will check the valid or invalid bit. So like this, these are the bits, these are the extra bit in the address. So finally, what we will do is we'll take these 36 bits to the TLB, and then TLB will be accessed using these 36 bits. These 36 bits will be used as an index to the TLB cache. Always remember, this is cache. TLB is a cache. These 36 bits will be used as an index to the cache. Then we will match the tag, and then we will find the physical address, that is frame number from the, what is the frame number? Okay, in TLB, we have only frame numbers, not the data. Data is actually stored in the data cache, or you can say in memory. If data is not found in data cache, we will search for the data in the main memory. So data is stored in the cache or main memory. Address is always stored in the TLB. TLB does not store any data. It only stores the addresses. Okay, physical address. So like this, we will find this address, and this we have 40 to 1 mux, in which means that we will, this mux will give only one page as one frame as a output. These 36 bits will be used as a select lines to this mux. According to these 36 bits, we will access the frame number. This frame number will be sent to, will be used to convert the this virtual address to physical address, like this. So if we have simple cache, the access method will be different. If we have a virtual address cache, virtually addressed cache, for example, we have this cache. These are the two architectures of cache: virtually indexed cache, virtually addressed cache, and physical address cache. What it means? Virtually indexed cache means we can access the cache with the virtual address directly. We do not need to convert virtual address to physical address. Physically addressed cache means we can access the cache only with the physical address. So we have to convert virtual address to physical address to access the data from the physically addressed cache. Okay, so let's look at this first one. This is physically addressed cache. Okay, you can see this is physically addressed cache. Why? How can you say this is physically addressed cache? Because CPU is giving virtual address, and this virtual address is converted using the page table which is stored in the TLB. Only after converting the virtual address to physical address, we will access the cache. If there is a cache hit, then we will access the data from cache. If there is a miss, okay, this is miss and this is hit. If there is a data, there is a hit, data will be sent to CPU. If there is a miss, we will search the data in the physical memory. Okay, that is primary memory. And primary memory can only be accessed with the physical address. Okay, so cache can be accessed with virtual address or physically addressed. So this is physically addressed cache because we are converting the virtual address to physical address first, then we are accessing the cache. What we can do is we have second option, that is a faster option, in which we can access the cache memory directly using the virtual address. Okay, you can see this TLB is placed after the virtual cache, after the virtual cache. So we can access the virtual cache directly with the virtual address. We do not need to convert virtual address to physical address. This will make the process fast. How we can access the virtual cache and TLB parallelly? Okay, how let's say this is your address P and D. What you will do is, this is offset and this is page number. Take the page number directly to the TLB, search page number in the TLB and search the data in the cache. Offset is your page number. You will access the offset, that is data, that is block size, this is page size. You will search this page in the cache and you will access, you will search for the page number in the TLB. Okay, if there is a TLB hit, then you can access the cache. So always remember, TLB access time should be less than virtual access cache memory access time. Okay, only then you can say that address is found or not found. If virtual cache is faster than TLB, which means you are directly accessing the virtual cache for data without searching the TLB. So first we will access the TLB for the page number. TLB will tell us that the page number is found in the TLB. Why we need TLB when cache is virtual cache? Okay, why we need TLB? TLB is only used to convert the virtual address to physical address. When we can access the cache with the virtual address, why we need TLB? We need TLB in case there is a miss in the virtual cache. Always, cache is a very small memory and is a subset of primary memory. Cache always stores the subset data of the primary memory. So if the data is not found in the virtual cache, what we will do is we will access the main memory, and main memory requires physical address. So we will access the main memory using the physical address, which will be converted using the TLB. So this is the case of miss. If there is a miss in the cache, in the virtual cache, then we need to convert this virtual address to physical address, then we will access the main memory. So this is the process of converting, this is the process of converting the virtual address to physical address and accessing the data. So in paging, what we do is, first we convert the physical address to virtual address to physical address, then we access the memory. Or what we can do is, we can directly take the virtual address to cache. So we are talking about the virtually addressed, or you can say virtually indexed physically tagged cache. Okay, what is the process of address conversion and access of the virtually addressed and physically tagged cache? Look at this diagram, this will clear everything. In your physically addressed cache, physical address cache means you can access the cache only with physical address. Okay, so this is your virtually indexed cache. Okay, virtual indexed cache, physically tagged, which we are talking about in the question. Okay, this is the question. Our question is only on the virtual indexed and physically tagged cache. So in this, what we are doing is we are taking the page number to TLB for search. For the search, if there is a miss in the cache, what we need to do is we need to convert the virtual address to physical address. That's why we are converting, and these two processes are parallel. As you can see, these two processes are parallel. Parallelly, we are searching the data in the cache memory, and parallelly we are converting the virtual address to the physical address. In case if there is a miss in the cache, we have to convert virtual address to physical address. Okay, now this is the important part which will help us to solve our question. This is the tag index. This is the index of the cache, and this is the offset of the cache. We always know that direct map cache interprets the address in three parts. Okay, this is the address format of the direct map cache, that is tag, index and offset. Okay, so this is the offset part, this is the index part, and this is the tag part. So these two combined, this is the index part, which means we will search the block using this index part in the cache memory. As you can see, we are using these L bits. L bits are index bits to index into the direct map cache. And the size of direct map cache is L plus B, that is offset bits and cache bit and index bits. Why I'm saying this? Because if your cache size is, let's say, your cache size is 4 MB and the block size is, let's say your block size is 128 KB. Okay, so number of blocks in this cache will be 2 to the power 22. Okay, that is 4 MB divided by 2 to the power 17, that is 128 KB. So this will be 22 minus 17, that is 5. Okay, 2 to the power 5. So number of blocks are 5, which means index part will be of 5 bits and your offset part will be of 17 bits. Okay, 17 bits. So 17 plus 5, 22. So this is the size of cache. 2 to the power 22 equals to 2 to the power L plus B. That means 5 plus 17, 22. Okay, that's why I'm saying this. So this is giving the page offset. Okay, so this, we are in the question, they are asking about the page, the size of the page, and the page offset will give the size of the page. But we know this part. Okay, in our question, the size of cache is given. It is given that it is 16-way set associative, and the block size is also given. So we know this part. This part is given to us, and we have to find this part. This part is indexing. This part is giving the page offset, but we do not know this part. Okay, that's why we have to calculate page number, the size of the page in a different way. How? Let's see how. So in our case is this. This is our question. Our question is actually set. In our question, we have a cache which is actually set associative cache. So this is virtual index physically tagged cache in which we have set associative cache. Okay, and this is the exact question which is our question. In our question, we have a 16-way set associative cache and virtual index physically tagged cache. In this, what we have is this my page number, which is being taken to TLB to search for the frame number and convert it to the frame number. This will work as a tag in the physical memory. And this is my set number, and this is my offset. Okay, this is my offset. Set number plus offset is giving the page size. Okay, this is not always true. I cannot say that page size is, the size of the page is equals to 2 to the power L plus B. I cannot say that. This is actually cache size. Okay, look at this. The size of the cache, that means 2 to the power C, should always be less than equals to 2 to the power P plus A. Okay, A is this bit. A is this bit. So we have to see what is this bit saying. This will help us to solve the second part of the question. Okay, this will help us to solve the second part of the question. In this question, what we are doing is we can observe one thing, and that one thing is the size of the cache is equal to the size of the page. Okay, size of the cache can only be less than or equal to the size of the page, or you can say size of the cache can be greater than or equal to the page size. Okay, greater than equal to the page size, as we will see in our question. So according to that diagram, we have a virtual address given in this question of 46 bits. Virtual address is of 46 bits. And in that question, you have seen we have divided the virtual address in two parts, in paging, that is page number and offset. Okay, by taking this offset, what we are doing is we are finding the offset, page offset, and then this is converted to, this is taken to TLB for conversion of frame number, and then we will combine frame number and offset to find the physical address. Okay, so we have to find this value, we have to find the page size, what is the size of a page in KB. Okay, let's see how we can find that. And we know that to store a page we have a cache. Okay, cache is 1 MB in size and it is 16 way set associative, and then the block size is 64 bytes. So number of blocks are in this cache, number of blocks are 2 to the power 20, that is cache size, divided by 2 to the power 6, that is block size. So 2 to the power 14, we have total number of blocks 2 to the power 14, but this is set associative cache. In one set we have 16 blocks. Okay, so number of sets are 2 to the power 14 divided by 2 to the power 4, that is 2 to the power 10 sets, which means, okay, as we have seen, we have divided this part in three parts. Okay, as we saw in last diagram, that is A, set number, and offset, that is, let's say, offset or part. So offset part is of 6 bits, offset part is of 6 bits, because we have block size of 64 bytes. 64 bytes means 2 to the power 6. So index offset part is of 6 bits. Index set index part is, indexing the set, we will require 10 bits. Okay, 10 bits. So these 10 plus 6 bits will help us to find the page size. Okay, page size. So can I directly say that page size of the page offset bits are 16 bits? No, I cannot say this directly, because I can say one thing, that the size of the page will be less than 2 to the power 16 bytes. Okay, or I can say in page offset, number of bits will be less than equals to 16 bits. Okay, they can be less than equals to 16 bits, but I cannot directly say that they are 16 bits, because this part is not given to me and we have 3-level page table. Okay, so this process will help me to solve the question number 94, but now I will see how I will solve this question with the help of this. So we have a page table. We have a page table entry of 4 bytes. Okay, and it is given that each page table in the this first level page table occupies exactly one page. Exactly one page. This will help me to solve. Okay, so let's say page size is, I am assuming page size is, let's say, p bytes. Okay, so number of pages will be in this, number of pages in this virtual memory, the size of the virtual memory will be 2 to the power 46. Why? Because the size, because the address of the virtual memory is of 46 bits. That's why size of virtual memory will be of 2 to the power 46 bytes. Okay, and the page size is p bytes. So number of pages will be virtual memory size divided by page size. So this will be the number of pages in the virtual memory. So, and we know that number of page table entries are equals to number of pages. Okay, so we can find the size of the page table. So size of level 3 page table. Okay, first we have to find the size of the level 3 page table. Level 3 page table stores the page table entries, actual page table entries. So size of level 3 page table will be, the number of entries are 2 to the power 46 divided by p, and the size of each entry is 4 bytes. Okay, so this will be the size of level 3 page table. Okay, so size of level 3 page table is 2 to the power 46 by p into 4 bytes, or you can say size of level 3 page table is 2 to the power 48 divided by p bytes. Okay, this is the size of the level 3 page table. Okay, 2 to the power 46 into 2 to the power 2, that is 2 to the power 48 divided by p size. So now what we will do is we will divide the level 3 page table into pages. Again, now we are not dividing the virtual memory into pages, we are dividing the page table into pages. So number of pages in level 3 page table. Okay, in level 3 page table. So we are dividing this page table, which is of 2 to the power 48 divided by p bytes into pages. So we have a page table of this size, and we have to divide this into pages, and the size of each page is p. So this will be 2 to the power 48 divided by p square. Okay, p square. This is the number of pages in the level 3 page table. So now this number, this pa we will store the base addresses of these page tables. We will store the number of ad base addresses of these page tables into the level 2 page table. So now what will happen is level 2 page table, we will have number of page table entries in level 2 page table will be equals to number of pages in the level 3 page table, that is 2 to the power 48 divided by p square. So num size of the level 2 page table will be what? Number of entries are these, and the size of each entry is 4 bytes into 4 bytes, that is 2 to the power 50 divided by p square. Next, what we will do is we will again divide this page table into pages, because we are using three level page table. Now again this page table will be divided into pages. So number of pages in level 2 page table, okay, level 2 page table equals to 2 to the power 50 divided by p square divided by p, that is 2 to the power 50 size of the page table divided by size of each page. So number of pages in page is in level 2 page table will be 2 to the power 50 divided by p cube. So number of entries in level 3 page table will be equals to number of pages in level 2 page table. Number of entries in level 3 page table will be equals to number of pages in level 2 page table, that is 2 to the power 50 divided by p cube. Okay, so the size of level 3 page table will be 2 to the power 50 divided by p cube into size of each entry, that is 4 bytes, or you can say 2 to the power 50 divided by p cube into 2 to the power 2, or you can say 2 to the power 52 divided by p cube. We will have 2 to the power 52 divided by p3 size of page table, level 3 page table, and it is given in the question that the page table of level 3 page table, the page table of level 3 will fit into exactly one page, and the size of page is p. So this means p equals to 2 to the power 52 divided by p cube. Okay, we have to fit this level 3 page table into one page, and the size of page is p. We have to find the value of p that we have assumed as the size of the page. And in the question, it is asked, they have asked the size of the page, that is p. So 2 to the power 52 equals to p to the power 4, or you can say p equals to 2 to the power 52 into 1 by 4. Okay, or you can say p equals to 13 bits. Okay, there will be 13 bits in the page offset size, 13 bits for page offset, which means the size of the page will be, if the we have 13 bits page offset, the size of the page will be 2 to the power 13, or you can say 8 kb. Okay, this is the answer for first question. The size of the page is 8 kb. What we have done is, yes, you should be aware of the concept of three level page table to find the size of the page simply. Okay, other informations given, which are we have a virtual index, physically tagged cache, and then we have a 16 MB, we have 1 MB 16-way set associative cache. This information is not required in the question number 93. This information will be required in the question number 94, that is next question. Now question number 94 is saying, Consider the data given in the above question, that is in question number 93. What is the minimum number of page colors needed to guarantee that no two synonyms, no two synonyms maps to different sets in the processor cache of this computer? So what we mean by no two synonyms maps to different sets in processor cache of this computer? Okay, this is the problem in the virtual indexed physically typed cache. What is the problem? Let's understand with the diagram. This is as well our virtual address. This is page number, and we take the page number to TLB to convert this into physical page number, that is frame number. Okay, so this will give me frame number, that is physical address. Now we are concerned with the data part. So this is virtual indexed cache, which means we are indexing the cache with the virtual address. We are indexing the cache with the virtual address. We are directly taking the virtual address and taking this to the cache. So as we have seen, we have divided this part in three parts, okay, because we are using a cache, and in this cache we have set number and offset and then index and then tag. So what is happening is, we have seen we have a 1 MB 16-way cache, 16-way set associative cache, block size with 64 bytes. So we have seen in the last part that number of sets in this cache will be 2 to the power 10, which means set index bit will require 10 bits and offset part requires 6 bits. And we take these 6 bits to the page offset. Okay, page offset. But we have calculated that page offset part is of 13 bits. In last question we have calculated the page offset part is of 13 bits, which means page size is of 8 KB, 2 to the power 13 bytes, that is 8 KB. So page offset part is of 13 bits and the index address is of 16 bits. Okay, you can write this virtual index, that is of 16. In cache, we have virtual index cache, we have 16 bit, that is C. Okay, the address of the cache. And the page offset is of 13 bits. The concept is this, if you are not understanding this, the concept is this, that we can store only one page in the cache memory. Okay, the size of the cache memory can be greater than or equal to the page size. Okay, so what we do is, we take this page, let's say pages of 8 KB, and we divide this page into the set, into the blocks, and we store these blocks into the cache using the set associative cache. So we have single page of the virtual memory. We are not storing more number of pages in the cache memory. We are storing only one page at a time in the cache memory. So that's why I have taken the 16 bits and 13 bits. So address of the virtual index of 16 bits and page offset of 13 bits. So in this case, what will happen is, it is possible that two virtual addresses will map to one single block. Okay, two virtual addresses may map. The problem is, let's write this down. What we want is no two synonym virtual addresses. Synonym means two same virtual addresses. No two synonym virtual address means map to different sets. Which means, this is given, not two synonyms map to different sets in the processor cache. What will happen is, if we have this gap between the cache address and page offset address, this is the gap between this address and this address. This is the 16 bit address, this is 13 bit address. In this case, what will happen is, multiple physical addresses will be in the multiple single physical address will be in the multiple sets. It is possible that same physical address, the same frame number, or you can say same frame, the data of the same frame is stored in the more than one sets. Okay, so this is actually wasting the cache memory. In cache memory we have redundancy, we have same frame in two sets. We do not want that. This problem is causing due to this address difference, because this address is of 16 bits, this is of 13 bits. So what we can do is, we can color the physical addresses, we can color the frames. What will happen is, if we color the frames, the cache memory can recognize that this is black color. So black color will be mapped to set number 1. All the physical addresses with the black color will be mapped to one cache set. Okay, So it is possible that we have multiple physical, we have single physical virtual address which will be mapped to multiple sets. Okay, so to remove this problem, this mean that this sentence means this simply means that a physical page, which I am saying frame, okay, which would mean a physical page could be in, this is the problem, could be in two different sets. Okay, two different sets. So we need to remove this gap between these addresses. Then we can say then the address of the set and the address of the page will be same. Okay, if we make this 16 bits and this is also 16 bits, so we can color the pages such that all the pages with the same color will be mapped to single set because we will have the same address. So what we need to do is we need to color the pages such that all the pages with the same color will be mapped to single set. Okay, all the physical addresses with this all the same physical addresses will be mapped to single set. Okay, how we can do this? We can actually simply we require 3 bits, 3 bits for coloring. Okay, 3 bits for coloring. If we have 3 bits for coloring, we can color the eight physical addresses. Okay, eight physical addresses. We can have 8 colors. 8 colors means we can all the physical addresses with the same color will go to the one set. So we will have 8 colors with the 3 bits. Okay, we require 8 colors because we have a gap of 3 bits with these addresses. Okay, with these addresses we have the gap of 3 bits. So we require 3 bits to color the pages, and with 3 pages we require 8 colors. Okay, with 3 pages with 3 bits we can color, we can have 8 colors. So this is simply asking the number of what is the minimum number of page colors needed to guarantee that no two synonyms map to different set in the processor cache of this computer. This is the problem in the virtual indexed physically tagged cache, and this can be removed by coloring the pages. Okay, that's how we can color the pages, by removing the gap between physical address and cache address. Okay, so the answer to this question is C. That is 8. And the answer for 93 question is 8 KB. Okay, size of the page is 8 KB.